Okay, how does it work? So in RFEM, when I run the BIM link, this one, there is add-on module, external modules, there is IDEA Statica connection. You have to run it. Note that I need also to run the results. Otherwise, the results are not transferred. So the results are run in the background for load case one. Okay. Then IDEA Statica launches. It will take some time. And here it is. This is called the code check manager. So if I move it a little bit here, you see that I have the option to import items into the project, make a selection in the partner program, RFM, and import joints and member. Let's see what happens if I do it. I make a selection here from right to left. And now the members and the node are selected. Okay, I press import connections. He will run the analysis of the, a test of import. And I see, okay, there's joint number 10. It's not joint 5, that is only my remark and my comment. Actually, it's node number 10. And he will recognize this. Yeah, there is member 7, member 6, and there's a joint. Yeah? Here you see the profiles. I have not set the loads, so I have to finish the loads. Definition of loads, like this. There's only one load case, it's very simple. Just click on next, 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 and you have the loads there. You can press finished, yeah, like this. And so now this one has been finished. I can do the same for the other ones, and I'm going to skip this one, but select only this one. So three members, yeah, like this, connections. Here you see that there is a node with three members, and there, I forgot to mention, there's always a support. It's not the same support as here, but see, IDEA runs a finite element calculation, so it needs a support. Yeah, and we put it at the bottom in this case. Yeah, it's not, it's a detailed calculation. So we need to have show deformations, for instance, relative to this support. So define loads again, next, 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 finish, and finish here. So now this one is, so I can open this one, and open number 6. Say open, then IDEA connection start. This was the program called Code Check Manager. And now IDEA connection starts. And he will import the data from the Code Check Manager. So geometry, materials, profiles, and end forces. And you'll see this result. If I take a look, what do I see here now? I'm in the tab page design. There's several tab pages I will explain to you later. Let's go first to the wireframe. IDEA Statica is a program with only one node, this one. And the mode is mostly in equilibrium in this case. Let's take a look. There is a normal force here, bending moment, shear force. If you calculate it, for instance, for the bending moments here, you can see clearly that there's equilibrium. 262 minus 199 is minus 62. That's okay. But there's a problem if you look carefully at the, in this case, for the shear forces and normal forces, there is a force missing. That is the minus 30 in this case. Yeah? And the problem is that these are end forces, yeah? But to take a look at the whole equilibrium of the node, there is also this nodal load, yeah? 30. And IDEA is not able to transfer nodal loads, no? So you have to do something with it. Yeah? So please be careful that in this case, to get equilibrium, you have to do something with the 30. We can, for instance, put it as a shear force here in the lower member. Okay, the other problem is, challenge, is that this is a continuous column. Yeah, normally, and not a set of free joining members. So what I can do, I can say, let's make a note here. I say, okay, there is a normal force in the top, minus 112. There is a shear force, and it is 52. And there is a bending moment, minus 199. So I'm going to cancel this member, in this case only, yeah, and make this, where the support is, make this one a continuous column, like this. Yeah. Then I can change the load effects. Yeah. Here is the normal force. Let's put them 112, like this, downwards. There was the shear force, 52, and there was 19, like this. Yeah. You see that is exactly the same as for member 5. This remains the same. And here are the unbalanced forces. Yeah. And the unbalanced forces are the forces that are acting. Let's show them here in this support. Yeah. So now it's completely equilibrium. Okay. Then the fun part starts. We're going to model the connection. So let's go to solid. And let's say, okay, I want to create, let's take a look at the bending moment, for instance. There is a negative bending moment here. Yeah. And so I have to create some lever arm so I can carry this bending moment. Yeah. So let's connect this member to the column. You can do it in multiple ways. You can add operations here, but the fun part is right mouse click on a member, say connect to column, like this. And then you can pick from a set of connections. There is the normal connection welded. There is a shear connection, these kinds, a stub. But for instance, let's start with this one. There is like a rip here. So let's use that one. It's automatically, he asks for the bolts. Let's start with M20, 8.8. There's the bolt assembly, 8.8, M20, for instance. Okay. And automatically, IDEA fills, connects it, and shows you a set of plates. By the way, IDEA is a finite element program which uses thin sheets of finite elements. So each profile is broken down, for instance, hold one, into a set of three plates, as you can see. Similar for the IPE, but also for end plates, like this one. And this rip here, that one. I will show you later more about the modeling. So we have an operation here, we call it an operation, and it is called end plate. And in the end plate, I can play with the size of the end plate like this, and automatically IDEA fills it in. I have to move this a little bit. Let's put it here. So there is the thickness, which I can change like for 20, like this. You see it changing here. Yeah? It's bolted, but you can select also welded. Yeah? And we dimensioning is relative to the profile in a symmetrical way. You see that the top and bottom is the same. It doesn't have to be that way. Yeah. So if I do this, you'll understand that it will extend. If we do this, you saw also that the length of the member is also extended. So let's do it again. Let's 200. You see that the length is extended. IDEA sort of cuts off the detail of the detail calculation. He does that based on the depth of the cross section. And it is roughly 1.5, two times the end of an operation that he extends the beam. Yeah, and you know this distortion areas, the D-gebieden, which is important in this case. So let's go back to 120. And so this is about the end plate. In one operation, we will set the end plate, maybe backing plate, the bolts and the welds. Yeah, let's take a look. We want to create, in this case, like this, the bolts here, and we can make it slightly bigger. We can say, okay, there is 35, 45 here, and it is also here. Yeah. If we make it slightly bigger, like this, yeah, we can extend a little bit the distance between the bolts, like this, and maybe this is 55 too, and this is maybe, I don't know, let's make it 75, like this. So this is how you play with the bolts, and it is automatically done in a symmetrical way in the other way. I can show you later that you can do it in any way you want. And the same is here for the widener here. You can say, okay, what is the depth? Let's make it slightly bigger. IDEA has come with this proposal. Let's do, oh. So like this, and this is the depth, which is 200, yeah? Okay, so this is maybe how we want to model this this joint. And now we can run the, analysis check like this, and we go to calculate. In 11 iterations, theoretically calculates the joint. And what he has done is, this is the traffic light. I will immediately skip to the mesh. That is for you important to understand. And say equivalent stress. He has break down all these plates into a mesh, yeah, like this and this. And he has applied the loads at the end using constraints to the web, for instance, and the bending moment and the normal force are all applied here at the end. What happens, and also in this case, so the here starts with deform in the cross section. Here there are some plates, bolts, bolt holes, welds, and they transfer all these deformations downwards to the support here. Yeah, this is what happens. So since we're using finite elements, we can deform the structure a little bit. This is also good to understand in this case. So in this case, you see the deformations like this. And I'm a little bit troubled since this is the exaggerated transformation, but I'm troubled since the bending moment is positive here. I don't know what in RFM it is negative. So maybe I made a mistake somewhere. Please, we always check if it is correct. Yeah. But you see a combination of tensile force, bending moment and shear that is causing these deformations. And we can see here that there is the T-stop is working. Yeah, if you take a good look. And the bolts are here. There's tension in the bolts. Yeah? So here is the prying force acting. You see that the sheets are coming, they're contact here, and here are they coming apart. Yeah? So it's good to check the deformation in the IDEA Statica. We can also check the web, but it is not, this analysis is just physical nonlinear analysis, and there is no buckling in it. So for instance, if this sheet of plate or ridener was really thin, it would buckle, but it is not in this analysis. It is only stress and strain. So let's take a look. And so this is the calculation of the stresses and the strains. But we can, when we have it, we can check individual components. Let's go back and take a look at the components. What I have here is plate, several plates, which I have to check. There is the weld and there are the bolts. Yeah? And we can check them according to the Eurocode. So if I run the check, the first thing he does, or the program does, is checking whether the design loads, these ones, can be carried. There's enough resistance in the joint to apply 100% of the loads. Yeah, that's the first check, the green mark here. Then there is the plate check. The plate check is on plastic strain. So if I check a plate, there's a breakdown into a set of plates, 6-1 for the profiles, the end plate, for instance, here. End plate, let's take a look at the end plate, equivalent stress. You see here the end plate. Yeah? And what he does is he checks the strain, but the strain is really low. For instance, in this case, there is a slight plastic strain here. You see plastification in this area for the bottom flange of member 3. That is this column. Yeah? You can see it here. You see here also how the bolt force, the bolt hole is modeled. There is a finite element, a refinement mesh around it. And so we check the plastic strain, and it is not allowed to be higher than 5%. This is the 5% that it comes from the Eurocode. If you take a look at the theoretical background of this program, you see a reference to this chapter where it's stated, where you can say set the limit to 5%. So we do not check it on stresses. You see here that the stress is slightly higher than 355, but that is due to numerical reasons. We have a material diagram. If we take a look at the stresses, I cannot show the diagram, I'm sorry. I will show it later in the report. But for numerical reasons, we allow the stress to become slightly higher than 355. Yeah? Do not worry, it's important to check the strains. Yeah? The next thing we check is the bolts. The bolts are loaded by tensile and shear forces. And for the shear force, it is a resultant shear force of the, in this case, the Y and Z forces. Let's take a look, bolt forces. Remember that they are here, for instance. You see here, there's a tensile force, symmetrical, 115. And if I check this bolt, it is bolt number 3. So let's take a look, there is load case 1, bolt 115, and there's also shear force. And hopefully you can slightly see it and move it. Zoom in, there is a shear force resultant in this direction. And when it comes down, it is slightly in this direction because of the deformation of the plates. Yeah, and roughly you can see that the resultant of all these shear forces is, it must be similar to this force. Huh? It's all these 12 bolts, they will carry part of the shear force. So this is checked, F, T, and F, and then table 3.4 of Eurocode 8, 1.8, Eurocode 3.1.8, where you have the resistance for tension, which is checked. There is the punching resistance check. There is the shear resistance check, and you see the formulas. And there is the bearing resistance check. And there's the Stuikweerstand in Dutch. Here you see the, for instance, the plate bearing resistance, which is different based on the location in the plate. Yeah? here's the utilization due to tension, there's the utilization for shear, and here's the interaction of two, yeah, which is according to table 3.4. If you utilize this all resistant concerning for tension, you don't have a lot left for shear. Yeah, that is what the interaction is set. So this is how you check the bolt. Similarly for anchors.
Emil, may I ask you why these vertical forces or shear forces are inclined in the bolts?
What do you mean by inclined?
Yeah, because they are not vertical.
Because of the deflection.
You mean it is because...
That is because of the model. There's a slight deflection here due in the plate, which causes it.
So local bending of the bolt is taken into account.
No. There's no bending component in the check.
Okay. No. I mean local. Why it is that?
This is the thin plate theory for this plate. It's causing this deflection, and this causes the slight. This inclination of the shear force. You would expect. Everything to be perfectly
vertical.
In that directly.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep. It is because of the model.
Yeah. Okay.
And then there's the weld check is also very important, and it's something to understand. If I zoom in, and let's take a look at this widener. I see here finite elements. They are representing the welds. Yeah, and they have each a different color. Yeah, there's a peak color red at the beginning, yeah, for instance, and there's one near the bolt holes. There's also one. So let's take a look at what happens with the weld. The weld is used to connect two plates, and that is logical. But we can say in the design, if it is, let's go to end plate. If hopefully you can see it, there is a flanges and webs, and you can say, okay, this is a fillet weld from left or front and the other side, or both double fillet or a butt weld or no weld. That is what we can do. Yeah. So let's go back to the check. In this case, it's a double, it's a double fillet. And so on both sides, we have we have a result, and what we internally have done, we modeled it as a plate. In real life, it is like a triangle, but we modeled it as a plate. We display the plate. We check, and now we do the check. Let's select this one. So I'm going to press plus again, and make it slightly bigger because the weld is, as you can see, the weld is located here. In red. And now I'm going to move this to the left. And here is the weld in equivalent stresses. Hopefully you can zoom. I cannot zoom it. There's 381 here. And then it drops over this length. And this is here. And there's a total of 8 finite elements in the weld. Yeah. Okay. So it's a constant stress here. And how do we check it? What we do is we take a look at, we use plastification in the weld. It's not elastic, it's plastification. We check the allowable stress at one point. And we check also the utilization of the whole of the weld over the length. So in this case, let's roughly take a look. It is weld number, this one. Let's scroll down. We see here the, let's go up here. Here is the status. So it's okay. Item, edge, it's a double fillet. This is the length. This is the length, 200, load case. This is all clear. Here it got, there is 381. This is symmetrical because it is double fillet. It's two times the same check. And here is the strain. Again, there's not a much strain in the weld. Yeah. And here is the stress perpendicular to the throat. Here's the shear stress parallel and perpendicular. And those are displayed. And then we have the utilization. First, we have 93% on this one. The total amount is 408. Yeah. And this is 381. This is what we calculate. You see the formulas here. Yeah. And UTC is the whole capacity of the well. It's roughly 40%, which is, yeah, I can imagine that if this is only 90%, that is, this is the whole area that we can use in flue pacification for the wells. This is how IDEA does it. This is how it is checked. Yeah. We have the same for anchors, for concrete blocks, the roughly you will get more items here if you check it. Since I do not have a lot of time, I would like to discuss with you, I'll continue with the stiffness. This was a check of the whole joint for stress and strains. But let's now calculate the stiffness of this member. So let's go back to the solid. I want to calculate if this connection I designed is rigid or flexible or maybe hinged. Yeah, we can do this. Let's take a look at the type of calculations here. There are four. There is EPS, which stands for strain. ST stands for stiffness. Then you have component design, is more for earthquakes. And then have you design resistance. You can calculate when the first items fail during ultimate limit state. But let's make a copy of this one and say, okay, this is a copy, and I want to calculate the stiffness. So I'm going to calculate the stiffness, and the stiffness can only be calculated one member at a time, because remember, go back to RFM, here is the node, and each member has a hinge, yeah, each one. So this one has, it is not that the stiffness is for the joint, no, it is for the connection from the member to the other members, yeah? To the joint, to the, yeah, to the node, to the joint. And this is we have to do. So we have to set, okay, I would like to calculate, go back to design, the stiffness of this one. Member 8, I say, okay, this is set to analyzed, okay? What happens then is that I have to put here some internal forces, yeah? And the rest of the, all the members are supported rigidly, yeah? They can deflect within the joint, yeah? But they are fixed here and here. And we calculate the rotation for the end forces for this member number 8, yeah, including the effects of the connection. So I've done this, set this to stiffness, go back to load effects. It is not necessary to apply all end forces here. I can say your code says you can do it for like only the bending moment. And let's do it only for the bending moments. Let's say put here a value, in this case, 100. Yeah. So this is done. Then I have to do a slightly other thing, is that for Eurocode, you have to define the theoretical length for when MY. That is required for the limits between stiff, flexible, and hinged. So I have to set this to 12, and then he calculates it in the proper way. Now, I will calculate it. It will take some time because he will calculate a huge bunch of points on the graph. So he starts. Let's see what happens. So to repeat, I have put here there. This member 8 is analyzed. There is a connection here. I set only MY as 100 as an internal end force, internal force. Yeah. And this is the result. So I calculated the rotational stiffness. Let's go directly to the rotational stiffness diagram. You see here what has been calculated. If I take a look, item 8, component MY, we can do it also for MZ, but it is and normal force and torsion, not so important. Here's the 100, and 100, here's the diagram. There's 100 here, and here is the rotation. Yeah? Let's take a look. This is the graph. The green line is the graph until the end, where there is complete rotation and the maximum bending moment is obtained. Yeah, IDEA calculates it. So this is the graph. And let's take a look at what we call the secant stiffness. The secant stiffness is the stiffness when I calculate the bending moment, for instance, and draw take a point here and draw a direct line back to the origin of the graph, and that's called the secant stiffness. This is in the code, it is not used, but it's for you to understand what the rotation is for 100 kilonewton meters. Yeah, okay, this is the number, this is the stiffness. How the code works is you have to, your code says you have to do it in the following way. You have to calculate the bending resistance of the joint, so the connection, what is the maximum capacity? And IDEA has calculated as 324. It's at this point. So it is here and you see it here. Yeah. And there's a lot of rotation here. So the stiffness is really small. So the Eureka says that is not realistic. We assume that at 2/3 of MJRD, there you have to calculate it. Yeah? Fortunately, it is almost linear elastic. Let's call it, you remember this diagram, you have it probably already in your course. There is a linear part, and then there's an elastoplastic part, and there's plastification part. Yeah? So this is approximately linear elastic or linear. And you see here that the values are exactly almost the same. Secant stiffness and the SJINI, that is the code, is 190 mega newton meter rad. Yeah? And this is the stiffness you have to use. Yeah? Then you can read also the rotational deformation, that is at 100, it is 0.8, it's roughly here. There is the maximum capacity that is needed for seismic design. There's the length that I filled in, and here are the limit values. Yeah. And there is the blue line. If the stiffness was below the blue line, it would be hinged. Yeah. Scharnierend in Dutch. If the value would be bigger than this, it would have been stiff. And this value is this orange line. You see here that between orange and blue, there is the wheel stiffness. So it means it is flexible, semi-rigid. Yeah, the classification. This is how IDEA does it. And here are the limits. And now if I want to calculate the frame in RFM, I have to take this one. Yeah. If you want to do it according to the code, it's 119. So I go back. Double click on the member, here's the hinge, and say okay, 119 E3 means mega newton meter rad. This is the stiffness that you have to fill in. Yeah, of course, if you want to really understand what works, you can put here the whole diagram. Yeah, but it is maybe too much. Yeah, yeah. But this is just a flexible stiffness, a rotational stiffness, if you, and this you have to do it manually. Yeah, so you can do it for each connecting member. Okay, then finally, let's make a report in IDEA again. You have to produce some results on paper. So go to the
Sorry, Emil, there is number here, production cost, 117 euros. Is that a complete that's complete connection here?
The cost. Bolts, yeah, the cost.
Yes, the cost.
Yeah, that is... we would like to... we have started an... how do you say it? Initiative together with the Dutch Steel Society to let engineers know roughly what the production cost of a joint is. So you can compare it when you compare it to other alternatives. So for instance, if you take a look here at design and you go to settings, you see here the cost of, let's say, what does a steel cost per kilo? Yeah. Or what does the weld cost, yeah, per kilo, etc. Those things are here, and in the end, we calculate what the total production cost is. So you have some idea of what a joint will cost. Yeah? It's also your responsibility as a designer to make the cost as low as possible. Yeah? So yes, this is starting point.
We will have.
It's not okay, finished. Absolutely not. You can do it much.
No,
better.
No, no. It is important just for the sake of reference, because one of the tasks will be to choose optimal, optimal topology of the joint with respect to the cost. Yeah. So it can be.
Yeah, and
it is important.
I think you agree that the less welding in the Netherlands is such that. Welding is done by some person, which is more expensive than, for instance, buy a slightly thicker plate. Huh? Plate is to buy a plate of 20 instead of making it a T-shaped with a lot of welding and stiffness here. And it's something you should know as a student or an engineer later, that make it as simple as possible. Yeah. Okay. Finally, the report, and we'll show you also the reference to the theoretical background. So there was the check here. Again, we are in a situation, there's a stiffness. There's the report here. The report is different to RFM. It is, it's generated in HTML. So you can easily export it to a Word, and it's based on sort of wizard. You can select here like theoretical background, and then you have to press refresh. If you take a look, I select all, then all the connections are selected. I can say, okay, I would like to see some formulas, for instance, and maybe also the cost estimation. You select it here. No, let's do it like this and say refresh. He calculates everything he needs in the background. For instance, maybe the stress analysis from the first one. And now the report is ready. There's the overview again. Here is the check of the stress and strain. Everything is okay. Note, when you make the, if it's not okay, it's clearly in red. We use colors, so you will see it. So here's the plates. There is the overview of the pictures. You can create your own pictures if you want to. There is the formula for the bolts, the welds, and there will be the cost estimation is here. This was the cost. And finally, we have this diagram with the stiffness. So this is roughly how to create a report. And finally, the theoretical background, of course. There's much more on the web, but if you print it, you will see here what the model is. We have like a material model where we have an idealized model. There is a contact between the end plate and the column flanges. There is the bolt. There is an interaction diagram for shear and tension, how we use it. There's a lot of stuff here. Yeah? You can read it and check how it is done. But more info is on idea-statica.com.